Hello. I know that Lithuania can become the hub for the successful crowdfunding platforms in Central Europe and in Eastern Europe. It can also be the hub for alternative refinancing in Eastern Europe or Central Europe. But however, a lot of things have been done. We have a good regulation of e-money, a good regulation of, perfect regulation for e-payments, but a lot of has to be done. And we have to work a lot on that. Today, I'm Vytautas Senavicius, chairman of the board of Lithuanian Peer-to-Peer and Crowdfunding Association. I'm also a partner at Law and TVINS. Today, I will deliver a presentation, Crowdfunding in Lithuania, a welcome to new players. I think that it should be interesting to hear how we are keeping new kids on the block, because we have regulation only as of 2015, August 1st, for P2P. So during my presentation, I will shortly, briefly tell you about the market overview in Lithuania. I will explain you the main bullet points for the regulation of the peer-to-peer and the crowdfunding in Lithuania. And I will also share some customs and trends which are now in Lithuania. So a lot of about Lithuania. Market overview. In Lithuania, we had a question whether to regulate the market, whether to regulate the crowd or not. And, in principle, we decided that, maybe the policymaker decided that, there should be regulation. So, in principle, why we need it? Because in Lithuania, we really felt that the financial crisis was had a huge impact on Lithuania. And, for instance, we had a failure of the bank which had 7% of all covered deposits in Lithuania. So, we felt that this is a problem, so next time we should do something ex ante to ensure that the regulation is quite strict to protect consumers and to protect investors. So this is why we have such decision, to have the regulations, so I mean the law on crowdfunding, which is now the draft is in parliament, and also to have the consumer credit law amendments, which ensure that we can work or we can provide services of peer-to-peer lending in Lithuania. In Lithuania, the market is small. For the P2P, the main players are Savi, Finbi, Manu, Paskolų Klubas. Two platforms hold approximately 90% of the market. And for crowdfunding, we are still waiting. So Savi, Finbi, the owners of Savi and Finbi are definitely considering to establish their crowdfunding platforms. Also, we have Paskolų Klubas and Lendi. Everybody are waiting for the law to enter into force, because currently crowdfunding, equity crowdfunding, is not available. We cannot do it in Lithuania with Lithuanian companies. This slide started with a question or with the statement, stricter regulation is better than no regulation. Why we have this statement when I talk about Lithuania? We have this because, in Lithuania, market is not so very developed, financial market. Therefore, the initial position was to create regulation which is quite strict and to see how it works. If it works okay, then we can loosen the strings and maybe to make it more easy for the business. And we are going that direction because currently in Lithuania we have regulation which took inspiration from the UK regulation, also from the MiFID made a huge impact. So I will tell you briefly what is the difference in Lithuania. Why I say that there is a peer-to-peer regulation and the crowdfunding regulation. In Lithuania, peer-to-peer is understandable as the business where a consumer lends to consumer. So it means that business cannot raise funds through peer-to-peer platforms. In Lithuania, what we have additionally, we have limits of 500 and 5,000 euros. What it means? 500 limit is for providing for the debt for the borrower during 12 months period. And the 5,000 euro is the limit which you cannot exceed when you are giving the loans to the all the investors in one platform in a 12 months period. Consumer credit rules applies, of course. When we talk about lending from consumer to consumer, then the law applies, which are related to consumers. So consumer protection. You also have to inform, to provide all information related to the borrower, and to provide the information regarding the platform conflict of interest in your platform web page. Of course, you should also in Lithuania. In advance comply with the requirements. I mean that you can start your activities only when you are in the list of Bank of Lithuania, supervisor institution. And what about crowdfunding? Well, currently, like I said, we have just a draft law. The aim of the law was to, first of all, protect investors and protect consumers. How they do this? They put the limit in the draft law of 1,000 euro, which you can invest during one year period into one platform. But currently we have a good constructive dialogue with the Minister of Finance and the Bank of Lithuania to change the rules because according to the current draft law. If you want to invest more than 1,000, you have to pass suitability and appropriateness tests. Well, and then all the responsibility goes to the platform, whether you are suitable or not to invest into crowdfunding platform. And when in Lithuania, it's a new business, you know, a lot of investors don't know a lot about that. So we are working, we are discussing that the limit should be higher and the requirements for the tests should be lower. That it would be enough to check to inform you about the risks, to give you a short questionnaire of 5-7 questions, and if everything is fine, or more or less, you can invest into the crowdfunding platform. Method inspiration. So this is what I mentioned, and what is important, and it was said already in the previous presentation, that conditions. Also depend upon amount to be raised. It means that if you want to raise more than 5 million euros during a 12-month period, you have to provide prospectus. If it's from 1,000 euro to 5 million, then it's the document which has the main information regarding the investment. So we are working and we are talking with the Ministry of Finance. Only a couple of days ago, I met the Minister of Finance and we talked about the crowdfunding regulation in Lithuania and they told that yes, it is a priority for Lithuania and I'm happy for that and I hope that this trend will also lead to the 2017 and we will have it, crowdfunding regulation and we'll have the players of crowdfunding in a couple of months in Lithuania. So, now let's talk about the customs and trends in Lithuania. Everything on one side is of course, I'm from Lithuania, so I'm talking from the good side. But there are really a lot of advantages on one side. On the other one, you should also take into account that it was really a good presentation, which was before, but cross-border activities is the gray area in Lithuania. I couldn't say that you are not allowed to provide activities in Lithuania at all, in principle, if you are the entity from the other member state, without approval of Bank of Lithuania, because it depends whether you are active, you are in the marketing of your business, whether you have even a platform in Lithuanian language or not, because nobody can on the other side say you that. Okay, you are from the other member state, so you cannot register to this account. So I think that it's still on case by case basis, and it's a question which has to be solved in pan-European level. Welcome procedure. Yes, you are welcome, but it can take some time because, like I told you, you have to draft documents, you have to provide information about the heads of the platform, you have to provide information what would happen if the platform fails to fulfill its obligations. So it can take approximately 2-3 months to be on the list of the Bank of Lithuania. And what is interesting that we are trying to to be in line with the other member states who allow to less burdensome know your client procedure. So I hope that in a couple of months we will have regulation which will allow to identify the client through the electronic means. So, dear colleagues, dear stakeholders, and I hope that this presentation was interesting for you, how we are keeping new kids. And I just want to say that, yes, you are welcome in Lithuania. If you are professional, you want to comply, and transparent. Thank you.